I have never been more inspired than when reading this book, The Ideal Smooth Cutting. It's full of pretty high-minded discussions between two very intelligent people. To become a better video editor, I watch tutorials on YouTube. But to become a better storyteller, that takes a little more insight. So today I'm going over my top 5 best video editing books that I think would be great additions to your collection and that would help you become a better storyteller. Number 1, The Conversations, Walter Murch and the Art of Editing Film by Michael Ondaatje. I love Walter Murch and his insight on film editing. I also prefer books that are more on the conversational side rather than the technical side, so this book is perfect for me as a video editor. Now, Murch edited both film and sound for The English Patient, which Ondaatje wrote. From there, they connected on their love of storytelling and their attention to detail. The Conversations got pretty deep, and it's a great book for those not only interested in the art of storytelling, but the concepts and psychology behind creating visual stories, and how the editor can best control what the viewer pays attention to and what is just slightly withheld from them until the right moment. The book is formatted as an interview between Walter and Michael, and again, it's full of pretty high-minded discussions between two very intelligent people, but explained in a comprehensive way that you can absorb easily. If you're interested in the true art of film, I highly recommend this book. Book number 2, Big Magic by Elizabeth Gilbert. I have never been more inspired to be creative than when reading this book. Elizabeth Gilbert is the author of Eat, Pray, Love, but in this book, she's going way beyond that and diving deep into the psyche of our insecure little brains and how we can push creativity to the forefront and live a more creative life. Big Magic is broken into 6 sections: courage, enchantment, permission, persistence, trust, and divinity. I wouldn't say that it gets too woo-woo, but just enough so you can learn the power behind your mind, behind your subconscious, and the skills you need to develop in order to be available for creativity to regularly stop by your place and ask if you need anything. While it's not directly a book on video editing, we all know how much creativity it takes to perform well as an editor. This book helps a lot with that, and I highly recommend it. Book number 3, On Film Editing, An Introduction to the Art of Film Construction by Edward Dmytryk. Dmytryk has 7 rules for cutting in this book, and they are an amazing source of reference if you're serious about being a video editor. There's a combination of hard technicals and psychological concepts here, with examples and experiences included throughout. Chapters include cutting dialogue, dissolves, the audience reaction, and the ideal smooth cutting. I actually got this book a long time ago, and I just noticed a portion that was highlighted, so I'm gonna read it. In a good film, the whole will always be greater than the sum of its parts. Every honest filmmaker strives to make a film which so enthralls the viewer that he lives and breathes only with the beings on the screen. Dmytryk has more than 50 years of experience, and he's sharing his take on video editing principles in this book. He also stresses the importance of the video editing process and how everyone on set should recognize that importance in order to create a polished film. Book number 4, Script Supervising and Film Continuity by Pat P. Miller. If you're anything like me, you really didn't know much about script supervising before even going to film school or even coming out of film school. Script supervisors are the medium between crazy, chaotic video footage and the overall creation of the piece. I'm super grateful that I got the opportunity to experience this world on my last show, and especially when it comes to editing for TV, this job is crazy and super necessary. So if you're interested in editing for big TV shows or movies, I highly recommend picking up this book or a book similar to it to understand script notes and how to follow along with a scriptee's notations. It can really help to train your brain on continuity and how to spot things like missed coverage, how to work with multiple cameras, and how to become a superb assistant editor to be able to decipher all this information for your editor. And for book number 5, you know I had to come back around on that Murch train. In the Blink of an Eye by Walter Murch. If you're not into the interview style of The Conversation, then In the Blink of an Eye may be the perfect book for you to learn creative concepts and editing insights by Murch. He discusses topics like what makes a good cut, continuity, dreaming versus reality, the cue to cut, and so much more. Murch even went so far as to revise his original publication to adapt to the technical advances that video editing has gone through. But no matter if you're trudging along through film strips or using advanced techniques, we all know that good editing stays the same. Since you made it this far into the video, go ahead and leave a like below and comment below if you have another book that has really helped you learn about video editing concepts or creative concepts or script continuity concepts. I love learning and I love the books that help you do that. So comment below with your favorite editing book. Hit subscribe for more tips on video editing, creative concepts, and freelance lifestyle. Thank you to my interns. Again, I'm Colleen and I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.